It is really a heartwarming. It is the happiest day in my life and the life of the entire family of Aminu Saad. I don't know what to say. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. The family thank, esteem, college, the ulama, and everybody whom effort is the result today we are seeing here. May Almighty Allah reward all of you. We hope, inshallah, in the near future, to see more of us in this college. Jazakumullahu kulla khair. Thank you so much.
MashaAllah, you know, I said it. Allahu Akbar. He's extremely happy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless Abu Bakr Amin Saad. Wallahi, this is a great achievement. We alleged it for your information. You are part of it. We are much, much aware that you told him that the only thing that you want him to achieve in this school is to memorize the Quran. Alhamdulillah, and he has memorized the Quran. Thank you for your contribution. We really appreciate it. Our target is for them to memorize in SS3. But because of what you did, alhamdulillah, he was able to achieve it in SS1. So who knows what he will do with the remaining 2 years, inshallah, in his team. I also want to appreciate the next parent, Al-Haji, or the father of Muhammad Abdullahi Baba Manu. Al-Haji, please come to the stage and show us your happiness. Bismillah.
Words cannot express how I'm feeling today. And we can only thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this great gift that he has given us. It wasn't easy. Muhammad knows he has gone through a lot of sleepless nights and lack of playing time, but it is worth it. We have seen what they have achieved. And we pray that this is going to be a shifa for them when they are going to Al-Jannah Firdaus.
Inshallah.
And I pray that the blessing will also be part of what the rest of the school and his classmates will get at the end of the day. And we will come back here and celebrate more of something like this. I cannot express how I'm feeling today, but what I want to just say is Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen for this great gift. MashaAllah, la quwwata illa billah. Alhamdulillah.
Allahu Akbar. Your effort towards this great achievement. Alhamdulillah. 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 Okay, before we move to the next item on agenda, permit me to appreciate the teachers. They have really worked hard. Without much wasting of time, let's move to item 8 on the agenda, which is chairman's remark. We are going to hand over the mic to our father, chairman of the occasion, Honorable
Santa Abladi. Because marrying the two systems of Western and Islamic education is a development which is trying to rectify the damage colonialists did to Islamic religion in Northern Nigeria and Nigeria in general. This is quite a remarkable achievement, and because all of us who are here today will go back home extremely happy with ourselves for the choice of this school, and what we have seen our children are doing right now, and if you project into the future, it looks very good. My congratulations goes to the students. This is the beginning, because when you finish reading the Quran, then the next stage is the recitation, after which you go into the field of knowledge. But you have the basic, and it equips you to confront the future. This is also, it inculcates discipline and taqwa in the students for their future life. I sincerely congratulate the staff for being consistent to see that the intention of the proprietors and the parents is achieved. And we are all witnesses to that today. I will not take too much time, rather I will tell you, this is one of the happiest moments of my life. And today, this is the most important occasion I have shared. I have shared so many, socially, politically, but this is the first time I'm sharing an occasion where the subject is Quran, recitation, and Quranic. Thank you very much, and I am sure the future of this institution is bright, and the students they are producing will have a very, very bright future. I'm satisfied because my third generation is one of the people, the students, who is graduating today. We never had this kind of chance during our time. The schools were designed to dissuade you or to discourage you from even learning Arabic or Quran. We used to have 2 periods of Arabic in a week and 20 periods of English and arithmetic in a week. And they chose the worst teacher to teach Arabic and Islamic studies. And not only that, the Arabic teacher is the one who is made to punish students if you commit any offense in the school. So it was calculated just to discourage and dissuade Islamic learning in the schools we attended in those days. But I'm happy this is a very successful experiment, and they are multiplying all over the country. Thank you very much.
Merciful. All praise are due to Allah. We thank Him, we glorify Him, and we seek for His help. As the topic implies that the ikhlas in the process of learning the Quran and teaching it. I'm going to base this talk on an ayah from the Quran and hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the Holy Quran, in Surah Al-Bayyinah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ حُنَفَاءَ وَيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran says, O Muhammad, tell them, I command them not for them to worship me with the sincerity of purpose. That's the bond of contention, the sincerity of purpose. If we look at the learning of the Holy Quran, it's an act of worship.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we should worship him with the sincerity of purpose. So any act of worship that has been done without ikhlas, it is categorized as a waste of time, because it is going to be a blame by the person on the day of judgment. So, for the learners of the Quran, the young ones and the adults, clear your minds when you are going to learn the Holy Quran. Not to be prominent and not to be praised by others, but you are going to learn it to earn the reward and to apply the teachings of the Holy Quran and to get the reward on the day of judgment. As for the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam narrated by Abu Huraira, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reported to have said, the first category of people that are going to be punished on the day of judgment, the number one on the list is the Hafiz al-Quran. Wal-iyadu-billah. The Hafiz al-Quran. But actually, what will happen is the Hafiz al-Quran will not apply the ikhlas in the process of his memorization of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will call the person who has memorized the Quran, recited it very well in the world, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask him, I have given you opportunity to memorize the Quran, and you have recited, and people praised you. What have you done with the Quran I have given you? And that servant of Allah will say, Ya Allah, I have memorized the Quran, recited it very well in the world, and I have worshipped you with the Quran you gave me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, Kadhabta, you are a liar. And all the angels will also say, Kadhabta, because that person recited the Quran just to be praised. He learned the Quran just to be praised, and he recited the Quran also to be praised by people, and he has been praised in the world. There won't be anything for him on the day of judgment. And the second person on that category is going to be a worthy person who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed with wealth, and he has been given zakat in the world. He gives zakat, he donates money to the schools, he does a lot of things that are praiseworthy, but he is doing it just for show off. And on the day of judgment, Allah will ask him, I've given you word, I've given you opportunity, what have you done with the word I gave you? And he will say, Ya Allah, you gave me, but I gave zakat, I gave sadaqat, I did a lot of things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, Kadhabt. The same thing will be done to him. And the last person on that category is a brave person who fought jihad in the world. He fought jihad, but just to be praised by others. The same question will be given to him on the day of judgment. I will give the same answer, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, Kadhabt. So the implication here is that anything that has been done without a class, it is going to be a blame on the person on the day of judgment. Lastly, we should always clear our mind and base our purpose on the ikhlas. That means the sincerity of purpose to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته
التكبير ما شاء الله استاذ اول جزاكم الله خيرا this is an impromptu you know topic given to him but he did justice to it استاذ جزاكم الله خيرا may Allah reward you abundantly for that so we'll go to the next item which is director's remark Alhaji Musa Bukar Sani is going to give his remark. MashaAllah.
Wassalatu wassalamu ala hatimil anbiya'i wal mursaleen wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Our distinguished chairman, our great father, distinguished Senator Issa Galaudu, the parents of the Hufaz and parents of graduates, all parents of Esteem Learning Center, relations and friends of the school, our dear teachers, our students, and our pupils, on behalf of the Board of Directors, I welcome you to Esteem Learning Center to yet again another graduation ceremony. We thank you for coming. We are happy that you were able to make it, and we are happy that today we have once again witnessed another Quran graduation ceremony. A ceremony like this is necessitated by the fact that we want to encourage other children to emulate the graduates. We hope that more of our pupils will do the same. We are also witnessing a new dimension. Last year, about 3 to maybe 5 of our boys that graduated from Esteem had completed the glorious Quran memorization. And this year, we have started seeing it from SS1. We hope every year we'll have more, and inshallah, we will raise the bar to that level, so that at least by the time the boys get to SS2, they would have memorized the Quran. May Allah make it easy for us. Let me take a special time to thank our teachers who have done great in training these boys, but also thank the parents, because these boys, particularly the 2 boys that have memorized the Quran, started from home. Abdullahi Babamano completed from Esteem Learning Center in Wuse Primary, and he had graduated the Quran, completed the Quran before coming to the Boys College. He had memorized the Quran, and that was great. But it is partly the effort, greatly the efforts of the parents. So what we are trying to say is that every child has the opportunity to do the same. All we need to do is try our best. You heard the Omanu's father. He said the boy has missed so many things. He has missed so many things in life, but he has achieved memorizing the glorious Quran. And nothing compares to that. So if we can deny them certain leisure, certain things that they want, and give them this Quran which they need, it will go a long way. May Allah make it easy for each and every one of us. May we reach a time when every child in the school would have memorized the Quran. I thank you so much for coming. We thank our teachers. May Allah bless you greatly. May Allah reward you here and hereafter. And may Allah bless the lessons learned by these boys and girls, so that Al-Jannatul Firdaws will be their final abode. May we also benefit from that. It is said that if you read one book of the Quran, you get 10 rewards. But if you also listen to it, you get reward. And we have listened to so many discussions today. May Allah reward us for all that we have heard. May Allah bless each and every one of you. May you return home safely. Thank you so much. May Allah bless you.
At-Takbir. Allah, thank you, sir, for that wonderful remark. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you, sir. Also, thank you for the dua. The next item is presentation of certificate to the graduates. Ustaz Awal. Ustaz Awal and Ustaz Ibrahim, are you ready? Allah barakallahu fiik wa fataha Allah alayk baba'inna at-takbir wa iskadija Ibrahim baba'inna hurry up At-Takbir. Allahu Akbar. The next is Mustafa Jamil Mustafa. At-Takbir. Mustafa Jamil
Mustafa. Wow, at takbir. It seems like they are related. Are they? Masha Allah. Grandfather to grandchild. Barakallahu fi. At takbir. Barakallahu fi. The next reciter is Ben Muhammad Lawa Habu. At-Takbir. Well done, Ben. At-Takbir. Allahu Akbar. Barakallahu fiik, Ben. Masha Allah. The next is Asiya Abu Bakr Shehu. At-Takbir. Asiya Abu Bakr Shehu. At-Takbir. Masha Allah. Small but mighty. Barakallahu fiik ya Asiya. Masha Allah. Now? Oh, Asiya is in primary three and she has finished the Quran. Barakallahu fiik. Asiya, ensure you complete the memorization before you leave primary school. Masha Allah. Okay, thank you, distinguished senator. Jazakumullah khairan. I would like to crave the indulgence of Alhaji Baba Manu. Please come to the stage and present to some of these reciters. Farida Abdullahi, At-Takbir. MashaAllah, At-Takbir. Allahu Akbar. Well done, Farida Abdullah. Masha Allah. Next is Aisha Usman Bello. At-Takbir. Barakallahu fiik. At-Takbir. Allahu Akbar. Masha Allah. Barakallahu fiik ya Aisha. Okay. Next is Farida Ade Adebayo. Allahu Akbar. At-Takbir. Are you waiting for me to make mistake? No? Oh, she's also in primary three. Masha Allah. Well done, Farida Ade Adebayo. At-Takbir. Now, the next is Faiza Abdullahi. At-Takbir. Well done, Faiza. Takbir. Allahu Akbar. Now, the next is Fatima Kabir Ahmed. At-Takbir. Fatima Kabir Ahmed. Masha Allah. Welcome, Fatima. At-Takbir. Allahu Akbar. Masha Allah. Barakallahu fiik ya Fatima. Jazakumullah khairan, Alhaji Baba Manu. We really appreciate you. Jazakumullah khairan. To invite the chairman of the occasion, person of Honorable Mustafa. Honorable Mustafa Khabib Zandan Duzi. Masha Allah. Okay, the next is Hafsa Ibrahim Suleiman At-Takbir. Hafsa Ibrahim Suleiman. I believe she's in grade 4, right? Masha Allah. That's wonderful. Okay. Usman Awal Abu Bakr At-Takbir. Masha Allah. Barakallahu fiik. Masha Allah. Hajara Talhatu Ibrahim At-Takbir. Masha Allah. Fatima Salih Bello At-Takbir. Masha Allah. The next is Amina Lawal Fari At-Takbir. The next is Sa'adatu Ibrahim Suleiman At-Takbir. Next is Aisha Aliyu Abbas At-Takbir. Next is Abdullah Sule Abu Bakr At-Takbir. Abdullah Sule Abu Bakr. Masha Allah. Well done, ya Abdullah. Next is Hajara Umayma Mustafa At-Takbir. Hajara Umayma Mustafa. ما شاء الله التكبير ما شاء الله and the next is Fatima Abba Mamman التكبير Fatima Abba Mamman التكبير ما شاء الله well done ما شاء الله. Thank you, Zandan Duzi. I'm sorry for keeping you too long. Being the chairman, that's why we kept you so long. Okay. Permit me to invite Hajia Binta Satomi to the high table. The next is Habiba Aminu Inwa At-Takbir. Masha Allah, well done Habiba. She looks small. Masha Allah. Barakallahu fiki ya Habiba. Fatima Abba Abdullah At-Takbir. At-Takbir. Masha Allah.
Maryam Iman Al-Hassan, At-Takbir. Masha Allah. Okay, thank you, Hajia Binta. Thank you so much. The next is Hajia Husaina, Baba Inna. Please come to the height, come on stage. Hawa Yakubu. Hawa Yakubu, Masha Allah. At-Takbir. Then Hawa Muhammad Dadan Garba. Hawa Muhammad Dadan Garba. At-Takbir. Masha Allah. Masha Allah. The next is Zainab Abu Bakr, At-Takbir. At-Takbir. Now, the next is Umma Kulthum Baba Kalli, At-Takbir. Masha Allah, Umma Kulthum Baba Kalli, At-Takbir. At-Takbir, Allahu Akbar. Thank you, Hajia. We really appreciate it. The next is Halimatu Saadia Abu Bakr, At-Takbir. Masha Allah. The next is Maryam Sanusi Abu Bakr, At-Takbir. Masha Allah. Maryam Rabiu Idris, At-Takbir. Saad. At-Takbir. Masha Allah. Thank you, Alaji. Jazakum Allah khairan. Now, the two of us to present a wonderful gift to this young man. Masha Allah, starting with Abu Bakr Aminu Sa'ad, who has memorized the Quran. Masha Allah, At-Takbir. Sir, you may wish to tell him.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Abu Bakr Sa'ad. Alhamdulillah, my Abu Bakr. This Quran has translation in it. After memorization, it's understanding the entire meaning of the glorious Quran. So as you can see, it has beautiful translations, well written. Can you read this ayah number 40 of Surah Al-Fusilat? The meaning.
And those whom they used to invoke before will fail them, and they will perceive that they have no place of refuge from Allah's punishment.
May Allah bless you and bless what you have read.
At-Takbir! Allahu Akbar!
I'm just opening randomly. I don't have any ayah in reference. This is Ash-Shu'ara, ayah number 167. Can you read the meaning for us?
They say, if you seize or not fruit, verily you will be one of those who are driven out.
MashaAllah, may Allah protect us from that.
Ameen.
I wish you all the best. May Allah bless you.
Thank you very much. Akbar.
Thank you. There is vote of thanks. Vote of thanks by the head teacher, Lokogoma, in person of Ms. Hawa Ahmed Aliyu. Mrs. Hawa Ahmed Aliyu, please come and give us a vote of thanks.
Good afternoon, my able directors, members of the high table, our respected parents who are seated here. We really appreciate your effort for taking all the trouble to be here with us. Without you, we won't be here today. Jazakumullahu khair for all your support and encouragement to these children and to the school. And may Allah continue to bless this their knowledge. That the knowledge should be beneficial to them, to the parents, and to the entire Muslim Ummah. May Allah continue to guide us all. Because as Muslim hold, as Islam holds education in a high value, I think education is the only channel where we can have social order in our society. May Allah continue to bless this great effort. And may this knowledge intercede for them, inshallah.
MashaAllah, thank you, Mrs. Hawa Ahmed Aliyu, head teacher of Lokogoma. Let me call Ustaz Sami Muhammad Ali to come and recite some beautiful verses. Just one or two verses from the Quran.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة. أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن. العزيز الحكيم.